You know what worked the last time we had a recession? Private label, the knockoff store brands that consumers embrace when they're feeling the pinch. Well, will that happen again this time? Consider the case of Perrigo, PRGO, which makes private label over-the-counter drugs as well as some generic prescription drugs. For the past 5 years, the generic pharma space has been a wasteland, just a total house of pain. But the coronavirus pandemic may be giving Perrigo a huge boost, both because people are stockpiling cheap over-the-counter drugs and because private label becomes a lot more attractive when millions of people lose their jobs. Sure enough, last night, Perrigo pre-announced some terrific first quarter sales numbers with 11% organic growth. People, that's amazing, double digit. When you back out currency fluctuations in the business they exited, well, the company's over-the-counter division was up 21% worldwide. Management cited, and I quote, a dramatic surge in demand in March related to the COVID-19 pandemic, end quote. Stock jumped nearly 4%, though it's still darn cheap, selling just 11 times next year's earnings estimates. Could this finally be Perrigo's time to shine? Let's take a closer look with Murray Kessler. He's the president CEO of Perrigo. To get a better sense of these numbers and where the company's headed, Mr. Kessler, welcome to Mad Money. Good to see you, sir.
Thanks. Glad to be here, Jim.
Okay, so Mr. Kessler, I know I thought this was an astounding month you had, but you did not raise your full year numbers. That makes me either think that you're very bullish on perhaps ending or eradicating COVID-19, or you're just being cautious, because I think this thing's unfortunately going to be with us for a long time.
Listen, if you understand Perrigo, we had a lot of momentum coming out of last year, and I'm a bit conservative by nature, and this isn't a reflection of the business or the way I'm looking at the forecast for the year. I think the demand will remain strong, and just as you pointed out, private label always does well in a recession. We're more than the surge in March, but the surge in March was, you know, keep in mind, we make over half of the United States acetaminophen, the Tylenol equivalent, in terms of volume. So that's in demand right now. But, you know, there's uncertainty around, you know, the ability to keep employees working and plants. And my first priority is to keep our heroic employees safe.
Now, you did have Voltaren, which is a drug that I use. You just got approval for that. The old days, I used to look at Perrigo as, well, what did they just get approval of? That would be the excitement. But now with the recession, which I think we all admit is on the horizon or here, I shouldn't just care about that you just got a very important drug like Voltaren to be able to be a Perrigo drug.
No, you shouldn't. You know, I'm from a pure consumer world where I came from. I worked at Clorox and Campbell Soup Company and others my whole career. And this has huge opportunity to grow this organization. And we got ourselves up to where we exited last year, growing 13, 14%. And we did that by redefining and transforming ourselves to a self-care company. So not only do I think the opportunity is tremendous for the company in terms of the recessionary period, but all trends are heading towards self-care. And I don't think in a new normal, everyone's going to be rushing to hospitals or doctors. They're going to try to treat themselves first. And with the line of consumer products that we have and the over-counter products we have, I think the company's perfectly positioned, to be frank.
Now, sir, can you tell me, with Wuhan open, they had 48 pill factories there. Does that impact the industry? We know that a lot of people in Congress are worried that pills are made elsewhere and that we should have control of them. Perhaps like we used to make a lot of them in Puerto Rico, or I lived in Fort Washington, Pennsylvania, where McNeil Labs was. I mean, are we going to start bringing pill making home?
Well, you know, for Perrigo, we're probably a little bit different than most, Jim, but we already make our pills at home. We have 24 manufacturing facilities in the United States. We make the majority of we sell 75% of the company's total volume in the United States, and we make most of that in the United States right now. So less of an issue for Perrigo, and frankly, that's what helped keep our businesses running through this crisis.
How many employees are able to go to your plants then? And do you take their temperature and make them wear masks at the facilities?
We are so strict right now. If you looked in our parking lots, there are medical stations. We take temperatures. We have constant questionnaires. Only essential employees can get into our manufacturing facilities right now. I mean, that's to say, if I went to our manufacturing facility, I could not get in.
Do you think that we're tough enough? because it sounds like Perrigo is the way it should be. I think this thing is not only not under control, but it's the most dangerous thing that may have ever occurred in our country because it's so easy to catch, even maybe worse than the Spanish flu if we're not careful.
Well, I think the world's going to be a lot different. I think we'll get through this, and we have great scientists and medical resources, and they'll figure out how to get to the vaccinations and the therapeutics. But I think you're going to see people behave a lot differently. I think you'll see a lot more masks being worn, especially on airplanes. I think you'll see a lot more virtual meetings, and I think you'll see a whole lot more self-care, which is what we've transformed the company to be.
Right. Now, let me go back to when I asked the question about where this stuff is made. I know a Perrigo. I happen to be friends with the old Perrigo team, so I know where it is. I just think that Congress is going to mandate that everybody has to do what you do. I really do think that's going to be possible. Do you think the other guys will be able to have low prices to compare with you? Because you're already cheaper than everybody. And I always figure if it's Perrigo, it's as good.
Well, listen, the FDA makes sure it's just as good. You know, all the equivalent products we make go through the same clinical trials and have to be exact. So we sell for 30 to 40% less. And you're, you know, with a lot of the name brands right now not available on the market, lots of consumers are getting to see that for themselves. But there's already a trend. We're growing all the time. But our brands, you know, whether it comes to acetaminophen or ibuprofen or one of the other 14,000 products we make, almost always on units, outsell the national brands. People have figured it out, and they'll continue to.
So, Murray, Perrigo lost its way. It used to be a stock, when we started this show, I recommended heavily. Was one time lived in Sellersville. I knew the company really well. And then it got caught up in a takeover that didn't work out. Management left. I actually was friendly with old management, but then the new management came in and they turned down the takeover bid. And the turmoil was such that I gave up on Perrigo, which is one of the reasons why I was so glad you wanted to come on the show. How do I know that the old Perrigo is really back, which is a great consumer company that you buy in an economic slowdown?
Jim, that's why I was brought in. I mean, I'm not going to talk to the past of the issues that you just raised, but I was brought in because my background and experience is all about focus. That's what I do. And I talk to every one of our employees. And when I speak to them, I talk about recapturing the Perrigo advantage. That's how we talk about it inside the company. We're all about going back to consumer self-care and the issues I talked about, which is what started 133 years ago with Luther Perrigo. And with the help of, you know, 11,000 incredible employees, especially the ones who are so heroic right now, coming to work and keeping our product lines going, I think you'll see great things from Perrigo to come.
All right. That's terrific. And also, thank you for your donation of cash and in kind for the American Red Cross, which I know is very desperately in need of blood, everybody, if you can give blood. And also to Meals on Wheels. Great to meet you, sir. Thank you so much for coming on Mad Money.
Thanks for having me.
That's Murray Kessler, President and CEO of Perrigo. If Perrigo's back, guys, it will be a monster stock. Made in America. Good to go. Mad Money's back after the break.
Don't miss a second of Mad Money. Follow at Jim Cramer on Twitter. Have a question? Tweet Cramer. Hashtag Mad Tweets. Send Jim an email to madmoney@cnbc.com or give us a call at 1-800-743-CNBC. Miss something? Head to madmoney.cnbc.com.